that is above every name. We thank you, Father, for beginning the good work within us. And you who have begun the good work within, you shall continue to do it. Father, we thank you that you the Alpha and you the Finisher. And you are greater than every need, every challenge, every conflict, everything that we face. Greater in you than it is in Indonesia. Greater in you that is in me. Hey, la la la. Than he that is in the world. Oh God, you dwelleth in me, you the man, I'm the branch. You're all the branches. We all receive strength and life. Yes, and blessings, fullness of joy. Joy unspeakable. Oh God, it all flows down through the branches. Give you the Nishi, Kiva, Shande. Father, we give you the praise for the Nishi, Tanda, because you are worthy. Everybody just lift your hands and say, Lord, you are worthy. Hey, hallelujah. Lord, you are worthy. Hey, hallelujah. Lord, you are worthy. And we give you the praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Everybody just say, in Jesus' name, amen. How many love the name that's above every name? Hey, hallelujah. How many know his peace in the name? Joy. Unspeakable, full of glory. It's all in the name of Jesus. All right, praise and hallelujah. We're going to begin, we're going to continue to focus our messages around the preparation that I feel that we need in order for us to pursue the vision, which are evangelism, and we're going to continue, everybody just let me following the example of Jesus. Amen. Doing the works of Jesus, following the example of Jesus. Amen. Now, today I'm going to focus more on the arena where Christ totally trusted and depended upon God for his anointing and power. And that's an area I feel that you could take some great lessons from Christ, because the scripture that we have been reading to you in Philippians, you might want to just turn there momentarily, that particular passage says this, look, let this man, well, let's look at Philippians 2 verse 4 through 7. We'll just read down to maybe 9 or 10. Look not every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of others. You know, that's a mouthful right there. Mm-hmm. Amen. Somebody said that's the recipe for blessings. How many want to be blessed, really, really blessed this year? Mm-hmm. Well, the secret is don't look upon your own life. And then don't center your life around your what? You need your things. Amen. It's all about sharing. Tell somebody it's all about sharing. Amen. It won't ever be fulfilled. I think all of the children,
praise God.
Amen. We want to get them involved in evangelism because they can minister right along with us. All right. So if you want mercy, the Bible says, blessed are the merciful, for they shall what? Obtain it. So if you want to be blessed, then you what? You bless somebody else. That's the way it works. Amen. So we're not going to be looking at all hogging our time, all, you know, our finances, our energy, our gifts, our talent, or, amen, our comfort or whatever. But we're going to have in mind the things of others, the things of others. Verse 5 says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. That's the type of mind Jesus And scripture says he didn't come to please himself. He didn't come to seek his own, but he came to seek the well-being of others. Who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. So this is the process that Jesus went through in order to become selfless. Selfless. Amen. And I think that that's the path that all of us should be seeking. Jesus said, if any man comes after me, let him what? Deny himself and take up the cross and follow me. All right. But made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of men. See, he was stripped of all of the glory power. Amen. Mighty glory and power. Mighty glory and power. That was the thing that he relinquished. His mighty power and glory. Everybody just said he gave, he left his mighty power and glory. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore, God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. I'm just going to go to one more passage that we've already established in 2 Corinthians. Amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 14 and 15. I love this passage. I love it. For the love of God constraineth us. That means continuously compels us, prompts us, pushes us. Amen. Because we thus judge that if one died for all, then we're all dead. Amen. All are dead. Christ died for us, then we're all dead. How many understand that when you're dead and your life is hidden in Christ, amen, you're not going to seek your own. Amen, you're not going to seek your own. I have an uncle which always gave this illustration. He said that if you went down to the cemetery and really began to talk to the deceased people that were underneath the ground there in the cemetery, you can say anything that you would like to say about them. Amen. And then he said, what will you hear after that? You can curse them out. You can beat the grave down. I mean, you can release all of your hostility toward them, vocalize it. But after it's all said and done, that person's not going to say anything. They're dead. Amen. Wouldn't it be good if we were dead to ourselves? Not seeking our own. Not always caught up, you know, doing the thing that pleases us. And that's where the power comes, when you, amen, get your mind and your focus away from what? Yourself. And begin to get it on the things that God wants, you know. I often give the illustration that The three things that God is primarily interested in is he wants people saved, he wants people filled with the Holy Spirit, and he wants people growing and maturing in him, because you will not be able to really fully carry out his will unless you grow up. He wants us to grow up spiritually. How many believe that?
Amen.
He wants us to grow up. Those are the three things that God is primarily interested in. And I think that until we are interested in the things that God is interested in, I think that we're going to lack that fulfillment, that growth, that development, that anointed life. Amen. You know, my life, amen, is, amen, scripture says, set your affection on things above and not on things of the earth.
Yes.
Is that right?
Amen.
Yeah. Amen. Set your affections on things what? Above. Seek ye first what? The kingdom of God.
Yes.
That's how to have a fulfilled life. That's how to get all of the virtues built into your life that will cause you to be successful and happy. You know, most people say, well, success for me, I just want to be, raise my children up in the fear and in the admonition of God. I just want my children to grow up and just be somebody that I can be proud of. How many want your children to have the best? Amen. I think this is what all of us want for our families. How many want to have, how many would like to have love? Love, I mean, you can't be fulfilled without what? Somebody loving. Amen. Amen. Nobody's interested in that. All right, success. Amen. Somebody want a good name. Bible says a good name is rather, you know, most people would choose that even above what? Silver and gold. It's more valuable than silver and gold. Amen. Sometimes people, you know, they have certain things in life. You know, I would like to have money enough to have an administrator here and have evangelism leader that you could pay.
Yeah.
And that could have children workers that you could pay a little something. And that wouldn't just, you know, cause such a hardship on just a few. I would like to have some of those things in place. Amen. And I believe that if we put God first, if we really lay down our lives, amen, just like this scripture here says in that 15th verse, and that he died for all, that they which live should not henceforth live unto themselves, but unto him which died for them and rose again. So that scripture is saying basically the same thing, that fullness of life and all of the things that you seek. The Bible says wisdom is the thing that perhaps is more valuable than what? Than silver and gold. Wisdom, wisdom. If you can get wisdom, all of the other stuff you seek will seek you out. Amen. All of the things you seek in life will what? Seek you. See, the Bible says the beginning of the fear of the Lord is the what? Beginning of wisdom. Through the fear of the Lord and humility, the Bible says it riches, what else? Riches, long life, amen, and honor. Those three things. Amen. I'm not just talking from the top of my head, Proverbs 22:4. So God is telling us how we can get the most important things working in our lives that can cause us to reap great rewards. Amen. This is 22:4. By humility and the fear of the Lord are riches. How many would like to have a lot more riches? You know, some people don't want much. People say, well, if I've got too much, I'll backslide. And I'll be going all, you know, all these places, traveling all over the world. Sooner or later, I'll probably just forget God. Amen. But I tell you, amen, the fear of the Lord, by humility and the fear of the Lord, are riches and honor. How many want to be about something?
Amen.
How many want respect?
Amen.
Amen. People
amen.
Respecting you and
amen.
Amen. You want to be a person of renown. Amen. And life. Well, that means life, long life. Quality of long quality life. Amen. So those are some of the things that God said that he would reward us if we could live a Jesus type life. A Jesus, everybody said, Jesus type. The Bible says that Jesus went about doing good, healing all of those that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. So he wasn't pleasing himself. And this is what Jesus said in Acts 10:38. You know, he totally, totally trusted and depended upon God for his anointing. How God anointed Jesus. So you get anointed, If you live a selfless life, you will be anointed. Man, it's just good to be anointed and just to keep the devil away from your house.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
It's good to be anointed, amen, to what? To call prosperity in when your money gets low.
Yeah. Amen.
Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Just get the Spirit of the Lord on you and in you.
All right.
Amen. Ain't no way you can go live.
All right.
That's the way I'm believing this year. I got to place myself in a position where God can meet every need that this ministry has. Amen. I mean financially. I can place myself, I can believe, amen. I don't have to, amen, just wait until y'all decide to give your tithe and offering. I can believe God for some stuff. Amen. Probably after one of God's good. Amen. Tithes and offerings most times does not meet all of the needs of any ministry. So y'all gonna have to prepare to release me for long because I got to place myself in a position. Amen. Where I can get help to get an administrator and all of these things the church needs. Amen. Well, we could have everything going big time. Amen. We had children ministry, had several, and we'd have to work Sister McLean and all that. Oh, I feel so bad about that. Sister Deborah and all of them. And had maybe 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 children workers that were trained and trained them to be a church. I'm believing for that this year. Y'all release me now. Y'all don't be looking around and say, where's Pastor Hill? Tying me down all the time where I can't, when I have to stay here all the time, I mean, just so much is going to come, right? Hallelujah! But I'm going to get selfless this year. I'm going to just let go and let God bless my socks off. Bring it back to the Lord's side as much as I can. Amen. Praise God. Y'all watching me. Now, last year when you know that I got a breakthrough in prayer. Amen. And I'm not ashamed to confess what God has done for me. And I say this all the time. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
All right.
Y'all scared to agree with God like me. The Spirit of the Lord is on me. He has anointed me.
Yes.
Ooh, glory, glory, glory.
Yes.
Whatever Jesus said, and whatever the Word says, I'm going to what? Land my what? Confession up with that. I'm just going to say the same thing.
Yeah.
Amen. He's anointed me.
Amen.
I'm anointed. I don't care what I put my hands to. I'm anointed. I'm anointed. Amen. Praise God for me. Finances flowing north side.
All right.
I'm anointed.
Yeah.
Amen. Sister Hill said, make sure some of it flowing 2049. Well, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He is anointed me to preach the gospel. How many believe the Lord has anointed me? Amen. Now, watch this. Evangelism, God has anointed me this year. Amen. Boldness, confidence, commitment, time and energy, whatever it takes. Amen. I believe Brother Walter's going to help them. We're going to get some young families in here and try to help them develop relationships and amen. Family relationships, marital skills, and all of that. Sister Jessica, we're already working on this financial piece, but we haven't really done any of these things justice because I think that if you sat down with the average family, if they really knew, if you had a plan, if you had information, if you had some type of method, And if you have some kind of concern for them, and you really desire to help them develop and grow in the relationship that they have with their families, I believe you would have a whole lot of people that would take it. You know, the problem is that, you know, we have all these things going on here, but nobody knows but us. It might take some TV spots. Right? Take some leg or some footwork too, right? There's a whole lot of it. Amen. And I don't believe that knocking on the door, you ought to be scared. With all that we have to offer people. Amen. I guarantee you, the information that we have forthcoming this year in the area of marriage, in the area of finances, the area of emotional health and healing. Amen. We just want to throw that in anyway. The women have been doing that on Tuesday night. We just want to throw that. How many need some emotional healing?
Amen.
How many do you know need some emotional healing?
Yes.
Yeah. Amen. Throw it in. Everybody said throw it in.
Throw it in.
Amen. Is the material in place?
Yes.
We're going to have to search for the books. It's already out, right? Now going over them, like, amen, you're going in even deeper. Amen? Even in the area of health and nutrition. Everywhere you look, people are what? Dying. Prematurely. Just because of the lack of information that we have in two books. Two books that we spent years putting together that to save hundreds and hundreds of people from premature death. And I think things like this should be shared with people. Yeah. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
All right. Is it time to go? Amen. Praise God. Now, Jesus said this. Jesus said that, he said that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. The Lord has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and the opening of the eyes to the blind. That was Luke 4:18. And I quoted Acts 10:38, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with them. All that were oppressed of the devil. That was Jesus' concern. Amen. Praise God. So I believe that if we become interested in the things that God is interested in, I think that our life will take on a different meaning. I think that we will begin to soar in blessings, and we will begin to reign. R-E-I-G-N. Reign in this. That means to rule and control and be in charge. Amen. Praise God. I believe that God wants us above only and not beneath. But we bring ourselves to the point where we become totally and completely dependent on what? On God. Because we can do nothing of ourselves. And it takes prayer. It takes laying your life down. It takes action. Moving out, stepping out, doing the works of Jesus. It takes all of that, amen, to bring all of this into reality. But totally trusting in Jesus and completely dependent upon God for His anointing and power is the thing that I am seeking this year. Amen. That's the reason why I cry out so hard in prayer. I said, Lord, I can't do this of myself. The challenge is just too great. The struggle is too hard. The people that we are trying to reach is just too difficult to do in the power of our own strength. And even in the church, you know, there's just so many variables involved, you know, that scheduling and people's availability and commitment and those that really share the vision. You know, just all of these things are all in play. And here I am trying to make it happen. Amen. But the scripture says We can do all things through who? Christ. So you have to become less selfless. I can't do this. The Father that dwelleth in me, he's the one that's got to do the works.
Hey, yes, Lord.
Hey, hallelujah. Yes. Amen. That's what Jesus said. Jesus said, see, Jesus was a person that was just like we are in terms of being able to carry out the will of God. Amen. I'm just going to read this. You can take it for whatever it's worth. I'm just going to read it. This is from my favorite book, Profile of a True Disciple. Amen. If you would just read this book, chapters 4 and 5 right now, I guarantee you, you would be just as happy as you could be. Amen. Once you read that and begin to apply it, you begin to get really happy. And I'm telling you, you'll begin to get what? Extremely happy when you begin to read this and step out and start what? Doing it. Amen. All right. Jesus performed all of the works that he was sent to do as a man anointed by God, and not as God, as he were in his pre-existent state. That encourages me. See, amen, he never took credit for one miracle or work he performed, nor for one sermon he taught or preached. He attributed all of the mighty deeds that were done through him to his Father and to the Holy Spirit. The Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. That's St. John 14, 10. I'm going to repeat that with me. The Father that dwelleth in me,
he doeth the work.
Say it again. The Father that dwelleth in me,
he doeth the work.
Suppose that was quickened within us. Lord, my sufficiency is not of myself, but it's the Father that dwelleth in me. He's the one that has the ability to what? Doeth the work. And he is the one that's what? Dwelling in me.
Yes.
Scripture
Amen.
Says that it's God that's, he that begun a good work in me, he's the one that will what? Continue to perform it. Hallelujah! Come on, lift your hands and say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah! 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 And this is what Jesus said, I cast out devils by the Spirit of God. That's what he said. So that shows that Jesus totally and completely depended upon God for his anointing and for his power. So if we are always trying to figure out how we can overcome some barrier, a situation, or deal with some type of health crisis, or family situation, or marriage crisis, or financial crisis, or a parental challenge, or some type of addiction, might be an eating addiction, amen, or depression, or whatever. Many times, we'll come to the conclusion, I can't do nothing about this. Amen. Sometimes we just give up and give in and just begin to feel sorry for ourselves because we see that the circumstances are just more than we are capable of what overcoming in the power of our own strength. So that's the mistake many times that we make because we think that we've got to get victory over this. I got to work this out. This health issue that I'm dealing with, or this unforgiveness crisis that I'm dealing with, or these children that's causing so much stress and heartache and pain. But we have to come to the realization, as Jesus said, I do nothing of myself. I can do nothing of myself. Amen. My sufficiency is of God. Everybody just lift your hands and say, my sufficiency.
My sufficiency.
Say it three times, my sufficiency.
My sufficiency
is of God. I can do all things.
I can do all things.
I'm going to say it again. I can do all things.
I can do all things.
Through Christ.
Through Christ.
that strengthens me.
How many things can you do?
How many crises can you get through? How many situations can you reverse? You can do all things through Christ. You need to practice that. Practice what? You're sitting with that. I said this. That's the reason why I know that I'm going to succeed big time this year, because I'm building this into my prayer every morning. I'm building it in. You might see me walk the aisle and say that the Father that dwelleth in me. I be thinking about all the challenges that I feel that are insurmountable in the natural. And then I begin to reflect, the Father that dwelleth in me, He doeth the work.
Yes. Hallelujah.
I just walk up and down the aisle. And sometimes I make a little song out of it. I'm just, I want to get way down in that.
Yes, Lord.
It's the Father in me that dwells in me. Not the Father that dwells in heaven, just in heaven. Amen. The Bible says Jesus is at the right hand of the Father. He's what? He's making intercession. He's pulling for me. Amen. I'm working with you. I can do all things through who?
Christ.
Then all my burdens, all my challenges, all of my disappointments, all of my frustrations and anxieties, I'm laying them down at the feet of Jesus. Greater is He. Ooh, I love that. Greater is He than is in me. Amen. I have to talk myself up to amen, to amen, to rejoicing. I want to feel like I'm reigning. The Bible says that have received abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness, they shall what? Reign.
Reign. Hallelujah.
I'm a ruler.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Lord. Yes. Yes.
I'm a ruler. Tell somebody and say, you a ruler. As long as you keep your mouth shut and want to agree with God.
Amen.
He was almost never said nothing. But to put the wrong thing, you magnify the problem. I'm not magnifying the problem. I got a whole lot that causes, amen, I could look at a whole lot of things that I'm trying to deal with, and I can say, well, ain't no way out of this. But I'm not looking at the problem. I'm not talking the problem.
All right, come on.
The Father that, doesn't that sound like the problem? The Father that dwelleth in me, He doeth the work.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Well, that means what? I'm releasing it. I ain't trying to muster up some strength that I ain't got.
That's right.
All right. Woo, Lord. I go back to another scripture. My sufficiency is not of myself.
Yes.
But my sufficiency is of God. Who have made us able ministers. I can do all things through who?
Christ. Thank you, Lord.
That strengthens me.
Amen.
Glory to God. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen. Amen.
Come on, lift your hand and say amen.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
The Bible said, Jesus said, because I love it, Jesus said, ye are, I'm the vine. You the branch.
My.
You can't bring forth fruit unless you're in me. You got to abide in me.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Because the same life force, the same energy,
all right,
the same wisdom, the same ability, whatever I need to get the job done. Coming from above. Boy, I will return nothing for what I have found.
All right.
My. That's good.
That's good. a present help. Boy, I'm so happy I can just cry.
Amen, amen.
That's the reason why these scriptures are so alive. I say them such a way. I say, fear thou not. I have got a tune for every scripture. Make this a way. I'm in a tune business. The making melody in my heart business. And I'm going to keep saying it until it gets in me so deep that it just becomes spontaneous. Calm down, baby. Yeah.
Ooh, that's good.
Amen. Sister Yosef is telling me to calm down. She got this. It was fixed 2,000 years ago.
Amen. Yes.
He's waiting for you to what? Agree with him.
Yes.
And said, what he has said about fear thou not, neither be thou dismayed, for I am thy God. I will what? Help thee. Oh, darling, I will help thee. This is Isaiah 41:10. I will help thee. I will what? Strengthen thee. I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness.
Yes, hallelujah.
God is the strength of my life.
Yes.
If the same life force that's flowing through the vine is flowing through the branch, I'm the branch.
Yes.
Yes. I'm the, tell yourself, I'm the branch.
I'm the branch.
And I'm in the vine.
Hey! Glory to God.
See, you wouldn't have no favorable expectations if you were in the vine. How many thank God that you're in the van?
Praise Him, hallelujah.
I'm in Him, and He's in me.
Yes.
He said, if you abide in me, and my word, that's the reason I sing the word, I say the word, I pray the word, I just, all of my life, everything I say, I try to get a song. I want this thing to get down in me, because this thing got to, amen, praise God, bring in $500,000.
Yes, yes. Hallelujah.
You believe you got enough? Go ahead.
Yes.
Amen.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Amen.
Hey, hallelujah. I will uphold you. Come on, lift your hands up. I will uphold you. Faithful is He that will do it.
Yes, He will. Yes, He is.
Covenant He'll never break.
Hallelujah.
Now you go alter the word. That's the reason why that word. You got to train yourself to teach yourself the word. You got to train yourself.
Yes.
Otherwise, hallelujah, there will be no victory. Bible says we overcome by the what? Blood. And the word of our testimony.
Amen.
Yes, amen, amen. Glory to God.
The scripture says He's able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can think or ask. How many can talk about some big stuff?
All right.
Yes.
How many got some deep stuff in your mind
glory
now? Don't see how you can get through it.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
He is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that you can think or ask.
That's good. Amen.
And it's according to the power
hallelujah
that's at work in me.
Amen.
Amen.
And I want to say big time, He is effectually working in me. My God.